Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome to the first episode of Test Dummy, a new series from PopSci, where we test trends for a week and then dive into the science behind them. I'm your test dummy, Jess Boddy, and this week I'm joined by my esteemed colleague, Claire Maldarelli.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
Yes.
Excited.
So blessed to have you. This week we are diving into trends about muscle recovery, and for that we have this contraption,
this Theragun.
This bad boy. What we know of it is that it's a massage gun, but I guess Theragun calls it a high-frequency, high-amplitude, neuromuscular percussive therapy device, and that it provides muscle activation, recovery, and pain relief.
It's a lot of good stuff if it does it all.
Yeah, right, if it delivers. Do you want to talk a little bit about what stories you like to get into?
Yeah, I'm interested in sort of like the science of exercise physiology and what sort of goes into how our muscles perform. And I'm training for a marathon. I ran a marathon last year, so I run a lot.
Is this like a trend that's been on your radar?
Yeah, it's so popular. You see it in like locker rooms, and all my running groups sort of have it, and people keep it in their backpacks, and after a long run, we'll go and use it. So I'm really curious as to first what it feels like, and then second, whether or not it works as it says it does.
So this is the machine itself. We're gonna try a few of the attachments. I believe this is the standard. Here, I'll do beauty blogger
style. I love it.
This is a standard attachment. It says for overall use.
Okay, so you can basically put that on any muscle on your body.
That feels really good.
It's amazing.
Then we have the dampener, and it's good for tender areas or around bones.
See, that's important because if I want to use it like near your shin, like your shin bone sticks out sometimes.
Should I do your shin?
Do it on my shin? All right, I'm really nervous. This is my bad area. Oh, that's delicate and nice.
The rest of these are the weird ones. We have the wedge, the big ball, large ball, big ball's funny, and the cone. Then there's the thumb.
Looks like a thumb.
And this is for lower back and trigger point therapy.
Oh, interesting. So like a lot of people get like knots in their back.
So there's also an app like for your smartphone device. And also online, they just have a few examples of things that might be useful to do, some areas that you might want to target. One, this is my favorite one, glutes, AKA
your butt.
So they say the average person sits for 12 hours a day, which is appalling to me, and that the Theragun can provide a quick burst of muscle reactivation throughout your day, waking up the biggest muscle in your body.
I can just stand up and take a lap around my office and do the same thing.
For $0. Okay, so let's now look at the specific claims that they're making online.
Yes.
Yeah, because that's gonna be really useful for us when we actually test this, and we're gonna speak to some experts, read some studies, and really see what kind of science backs this up or maybe doesn't back it up. On their website, they say, quote, all it takes is 30 seconds per muscle group to improve muscle strength, flexibility, coordination, and performance. After an intense workout, it works deep to relieve soreness and speed up recovery.
That's a lot of claims for 30 seconds.
I'm with you. Yeah, I mean, per muscle group, so I guess that would be like 5 minutes?
True.
Your whole overall body,
right.
not 30 seconds.
But
still, I mean, 30 seconds for all of those benefits seems like a lot. But
seems
we'll see.
Small.
Okay, so how are we actually going to test this? I think the main...
Love tests.
Do you?
No.
I was gonna say. I think the main one is that we're interested in is improving our recovery. My favorite day to lift is leg day, hands down. But you know when you get off a busy subway and you're walking up the steps and all of those people are behind you?
And they're like, hurry it up.
Yes.
And you're like...
And you're like, I'm so sore, I'm really sorry.
Each step... is like a mountain.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm hoping that Theragun might be able to improve my recovery enough that I don't.
So you can sprint up those stairs.
Yes, so the crowd behind me doesn't turn into an angry mob. So that's me. That's going to be my main measure. But what about you?
Yeah, I mean, I'm in the middle of marathon training right now. So I'm hoping that if I use the Theragun throughout the week, I will feel refreshed and energized and ready to go.
So now that we've kind of, you know, looked into all of this and we've laid out our questions and things we want to learn more about, I guess the only thing left is to try it. Hello, hello. It's Tuesday morning. I am walking back from the gym right now. I did leg day. It was great. But I'm really hurting. I'm looking forward to using the Theragun and hopefully my pain will be remedied. We'll see. Hello. Yeah, this is not half bad at all. I definitely don't mind this. If I'm sore tomorrow, we'll see like if this can help that. Like I'm kind of trying to see if it can replace foam rolling at all, like if it'll compare to that. So yeah, I'm about to leave for work, but I left myself with 5 extra minutes to do this. I am sore. Let's try this. Okay, we're back. It's been 7 days, it's been a week.
Full week.
What do you think? What's your impression?
The device is super fun, so it wasn't a drag to use it. I just, like, every time after I finished any run or hard workout, I was excited to use it.
I had a similar experience. I don't think my trip up the subway stairs was any easier, but
right.
I think, you know, after I would lift and get sore and use it, like, it would feel better.
What was your favorite attachment?
That's a good question. I mostly stuck with like the standard one.
Yeah.
I will say that I liked the thumb.
I loved the thumb.
I loved the thumb.
The thumb was a good size.
Where did you use the thumb?
On my calves and like right between nice. My shin and my calf muscle.
The thumb was so good for my neck and like my shoulders.
Oh, see, I didn't
tried.
Really use that there.
Okay, I recommend it. But that is just N=2. It's not like we're in a controlled scientific study. We're just two gals trying out.
Just two athletic gals.
Yeah. Let's dive into what we found in our research and interviews.
Unlike other recovery mechanisms like foam rollers or those like crazy Normatec boots, like space boots, there have not been any controlled, placebo-controlled, like double-blind studies on the Theragun. So it's hard to say like how it actually works and how effective it is when there's not been any studies on it. But what I found a bunch of researchers have been saying is that it works for like very quick effects. There's that thing called the delayed onset muscle soreness, or DOMS as it's nicely referred to. And so for that pain that you feel, the Theragun can be really useful for that.
It's funny to me that we don't know how this works, basically, and it's just so popular.
Right.
Like, I think the first time I really saw it was Kyrie Irving in the 2017
yes.
NBA Finals. Now, like, Nordstrom stocks it, and it's sold out.
I cannot believe Nordstrom
has it. Yeah, they sold it in, like, their tech pop-up. The most advanced model that we have is $600. I mean, that's a lot of money to pay for something that you don't know exactly what it's doing to you. And it's also interesting to talk about, like, how pain is so subjective and pain relief is so subjective. I know you and I talk about this a lot. We find
yes.
it really interesting. And I actually interviewed somebody about this, Dr. Jonathan Fader, who is a sports psychologist. He does really cool work. He's worked with the New York Giants. I think he's worked with the Mets as well. Specifically with things like the Theragun, he was saying that the placebo effect is like very much in play here. And so the placebo effect is basically when we receive a treatment that really doesn't have any physical effect on us, but it makes us feel better anyway.
There's been placebo effects for basically everything. Like, I think it's crazy.
That's what he said, that even when you take medicine that does work, like if you take Advil, you might start to feel better before it even kicks in, because you know that you're starting to help yourself.
You know it's coming.
Dr. Fader provided a Jane Austen quote to talk about the placebo effect.
Oh, please tell.
He says, "It isn't what we say or think that defines us, but what we do."
Oh, wow.
I love a Jane Austen application for the placebo.
I don't think I've ever had Jane Austen in a science story video.
Me neither.
Ever. So
yeah, I loved it.
And then another a kinesiologist that I talked to, Nicole Dobbs, who's at California State University San Bernardino, was telling me that muscle damage and the pain that's associated with it are not linearly connected. So the more muscle damage you have doesn't always mean more pain. So it's really hard to judge how these tools work based on pain because it's so subjective.
Yeah, and I will add the last thing that Dr. Fader told me in relation to this was that if you see celebrities or somebody that you really respect using like a muscle recovery device, for instance, the Theragun.
Like, I need to get on this.
Right, and you perceive it as being more effective. Okay, so what's our verdict? What do we think? I guess if it makes you feel better and you have the cash to burn,
right. And it
Why not?
Okay, so if I had the cash to burn, honestly, like, it makes recovery fun. And kind of similar to, I have this running coach who would always tell me, you should wear clothes that you like and that you think look good, because if you feel good and you think you look good, then you'll run well.
I love that.
So, like, this idea that none of this makes any difference is unfounded based on what we know about psychology. And one last thing to note is that, you know, there are all these muscle recovery devices on the market in addition to Theragun. But I think one thing that people forget, that the number one effective muscle recovery device is sleep itself.
Getting
plus hours of sleep will do far more than any of these devices combined. And that's because there's so many like cellular mechanisms that go on with recovery, like muscle recovery, cell recovery, that only happen during sleep. And so as fun as this is, nothing beats a good night of rest.
I could really use a good night of rest.
Same.
The main takeaway from this, like, get a good night's sleep no matter what. Like, that's your baseline. And then whatever muscle recovery activity or device works for you, like, I think that's what you should do. If we're making ourselves feel less pain and making ourselves feel better, then we do perform better. So that's all you can ask for. There you have it. Thanks for watching. If you want us to try something on Test Dummy, drop it in the comments below, and also make sure to hit subscribe. Next week, we will be trying meditation apps. So this week we recovered our muscles. Next week, we'll be recovering our minds. Bye.